Ту-ту-ту-ту-ту-ту. Таранигма. Objectively one of the best, if not the best, RPGs in history. Right? Objectively, it's like, it's one of the, my personal high tier list, right? Games what got their own philosophy actually inside of them, right? Same with Planescape Torment, Mask of Betrayer, Xenogears, and maybe Nerim and Enderal both, actually, right? So this game, like, you can't even call it a game, actually, to be perfectly honest, right? But, it's like, above all that, what, it's one of the most beautiful, actually, and goodest, I suppose, action RPGs, right, on Super Nintendo, both with Alkahest, right? And it's kind of funny, what Alkahest is supposed to be just not that popular, right? But the game totally deserves every attention, right? Because it's been produced and made by ex-chief of Nintendo, actually, right? Just so you know. And it's like, why I really like Terranigma and games like Planescape Torment and Terranigma both, actually, right? Or Xenogears, because they got their own philosophy, actually, right? It's like, the music, aesthetics and atmosphere is unique and insane, right? How a game chemistry is work with you. But it's kind of funny, what after the first time heard about Terranigma, I thought like, okay, it's like, it's a good action RPG, good looking game, actually, what supposed to be kind of like JRPG looking, right? And it's supposed to be a JRPG, action JRPG, right? And starts with very simple story. You just, it's like, you just, talk to your regular and just happy village characters, I suppose. And just the characters were supposed to live in this happy, beautiful village of JRPG, fantasy, anime-styled game, actually, right? And it's like, you got an elder inside of this village was supposed to ask you to just go and conquer and and open this towers, right? But when you first time go out on the village, right? You just totally understand that something is going wrong, actually, right? Because this village is supposed to be some sort of weird oasis, I suppose, right? In the middle of a grey waste of some sort, right? And you need to go and just defeat all these weird enemies and bosses actually inside of these towers, right? And you'd be like, well, that's that, right? That's the game. But no, it was basically a tutorial, right? It was just a tutorial for you to just start an epic story about reshaping the world, basically, by your own hands, right? Because Ark, being in the main character of this game, he basically being like a messiah and a tool of shaping the world. It's like, it's this combination, this weird combination of events, right? What happened to him, actually, right? Basically make you some sort of a god, actually, right? Was supposed to reshape the world and remake it, remade it, right? At some point. But, you see, it's like, the game is extremely attractive when you start to fight, actually, right? Almost like in new East games, like East 7, right? And it's kind of funny to remember what East is supposed to be this, to have this weird ram system, right? When you basically ramming an enemy, right? You're not supposed to just fight them like in regular JRPG. You're not supposed to swing your weapon, and you're just ramming the enemy basically in East Chronicles, for example, or East Book 1 and 2, right? But this game is really just you can compare this game to East, actually, right? Because it's like, you got this typical Fantasy anime JRPG character, I don't just or universe, right? Or just aesthetics, right? But it's just convinced you to just what this game is something bigger than this. And I'm not whining about like anime looking games, right? Or JRPG happy fantasy looking games, right? I mean, this game just pretend, but it's just a little cute rabbit, right? But it's occasionally it's become a rabbit from the Monty Python comedy show, you know? This is a very dangerous and extremely big adventure, actually, right? Was just waiting for you, right? And you just think what is just some little game what you supposed to, where you supposed to just have a dungeon crawler of some sort, right? When you just enter these towers, right, around your village. But it's not it, right? It's just only the beginning. And it's continued to be the story where you just basically, just talk and learn and fight through where just, this game, right? This game got extraordinary different landscape, world map, all this classic RPG stuff what you are supposed to have, right? But the way how the game talk to you, right? And feels, this is where just pure quintet for you, right? We're supposed to be a developer, right? Of the games like Obsidian or Black Isle, we're supposed to put something bigger when this feeling what you you are supposed to be a developer of a game or developers of the games, right? Well, we're supposed to put some aesthetics inside of it, like Persona games, right? This game meant to be cool, right? But some people put a vision, right? And ask these extremely hard questions like what is love in the face of fate, right? What is fate? What is much more important to you? Love or your fate, right? Like in Mask of Betrayer, right? What are you just supposed to sacrifice for your believings, right? Same goes with Terra Enigma, right? Everybody will just tell you what the god sin in this game are supposed to be the high peak of this game in nutshell, right? This is the Terra Enigma in nutshell, actually, right? It just pretend to be just a JRPG action game, but the game got its own philosophy, right? Above that, the game got some extremely unique chemistry, right? But I just continue to talk about the unique chemistry from episode to episode, right, in RPG Legends, but that's why we just been the part of the RPG Legends in nutshell, right? Because every game got their own chemistry, right? It's extremely unique, powerful feeling inside of you when you start to play and you realize what this game is something bigger than our games what you actually play, right? That's why any JRPG or RPG fan, at some point if you play regular games or MMO, for example, right, you totally understand what that's the true feeling of having a aesthetic and unique pleasure of playing the game, right? Because the game just stopped to be game, it's become guidance, like some book, Ken Kesey book, right? Or Kurt Vonnegut books, for example, right? And that's what you need to know about Terra Enigma, right? It start to be this game what pretend to be regular action RPG, but it's become this epic philosophical revelation for you. This game is a revelation. You can read Bible and you can beat this game and feel the difference, actually, for sake the game was supposed to just teach you, I don't just, it's like, how life is precious, actually, which is Terranigma, right? And how you need to respect the balance in all things, actually, right? Even if it's supposed to be kind of unfair toward to you, right? But you're not supposed to give up. You need to continue to just be a decent person, actually, right? And care about the world around you. That's the Terranigma for you. That's why it's called Terranigma in the first place, right? And that's why Quintet is supposed to just continue to be a legend among legends as a game developer, right? Quintet is basically Dead Obsidian, actually, from the East, right? Or from Japan, right? If a Black Isles Studios at some point, and Obsidian still exists, and BioWare even, right? But they just lost with all, big creators inside of them. Example, it's Chris Avellone, right? From Obsidian. They just fire him, right? Or he get fired himself, actually, right? He quit, as far as I remember. Or they got this weird, drama, what well, just he need to left, actually, right? But I mean, it's kind of funny, what, you know, just in game industry, you got, like, examples, like, what the games are not supposed to be, popular, or they not supposed to sell well, but they just continue to just left their mark on in the hearts of the players, right? Example, it's Kingdoms of Amalur: Reckoning, Planescape Torment, and Terranigma as well, actually, to be perfectly honest, right? Because this game is a legend among legends. It's a myth, right? It's Terranigma. If you ever... if you ever ask yourself, like, why all these gamers is just so hype about new games, right? Why they continue to be gamers? We continue to be gamers for the games like this, for the games like Terranigma. Because Terranigma is just best of the best, right? It's high rank S tier game with its own philosophy. You can compare this game only to some creations like Shadow of the Colossus or Ica, for example, right? Or Prince of Persia, War of Rifin, if you're not taking the pure RPG genre, right? And you can compare games like Terranigma only to games like Xenogears, right? Or Planescape Torment. But you got a lot of people in America, for example, right? Who just play, only JRPGs, right? Or only CRPGs. JRPG community is much more larger in America, to be perfectly honest, right? Compared to regular CRPG, right? Or RPGs from BioWare, for example, right? But I'm not supposed to be this snob, I suppose, right? Who just play only JRPG, right? It's kind of funny what Super Derek once upon a time said, well, you know what, you're not supposed to be JRPG snob, right? But you want to ask Super Derek, why you only play only console games, man? If you're not supposed to be a JRPG snob, man. You know? It's kind of funny what people just continue to play only JRPG or JRPG action RPGs, right? Or only tactical RPGs, right? But I'm totally not one of them, right? I totally can compare, actually, right? It's like, if you play something like Planescape Torment, the game was supposed to look extremely grim, right? And have these tough choices throughout the story, right? You got the dialogue options, you can talk to characters like it's human being, right? And in this game, mostly you just fight an enemies, right? Like in Dungeon Crawler, right? And you got some dialogues, but they're supposed to be you're not supposed to have a choice in the dialogues, right? Like, you're not supposed to just talk to some characters like in Planescape Torment, obviously, right? But you totally feel how this game is supposed to be big, right? So, that's why I want to put know, just this game on the very high spot, actually, right? And it's need to be, it's must, right? Be in the museum of RPGs, of games, just gaming history itself, I don't know, just, right? The museum of game industry, I don't know, just, I suppose, right? Because this game is a pure example of what, why the game is supposed to be art. Because people are continued to just, you know, just, even in America, actually, right? They just continue to say what games are supposed to be all about violence, right? Even the game critics, actually, they, just like the creator of Braid, right? Are supposed to say what the only thing we do in games is basically just fighting, right? We're fighting, we're killing, and just, we kill some, creatures, I suppose, right? And that's that. That's the core gameplay, right? It's like basically all of the gameplay in any game is basically just being based around violence, right? But you totally will feel the difference when you play Diablo 2, for example, and you play Terranigma, right? Both of them have a fighting, right? Just core mechanics, actually. Like in Diablo, you need to just kill monsters, right? Because it's hack and slash RPG. And you need to kill creatures in Terranigma as well. But it's like the difference between the aesthetics and atmosphere, right? And the philosophy, right? Because the Diablo not supposed to have a philosophy inside of it, right? It's just typical cool game from Blizzard, right? Good old, just old-fashioned Blizzard, right? Or Silicon and Synapse, like Lost Vikings, right? Or Rock'n'Roll Racing. But this game will prove to anyone what the games are just high rank, just tier of art, right? This game, just this creation go beyond the cinema, right? Or any movie, I suppose. Go beyond any book. It just crash through the wall of, of like the wall what you supposed to construct. And have this believing what games are just supposed to be just the games, right? It's not supposed to teach you anything, right? This game will prove you wrong. It will crush your soul and just in the end you totally will feel it, actually, right? What is supposed to be some emptiness in your soul, actually, right? Because it's just this game like a good friend that you know sometime, right? And you lost him, right? Or your neighbor, you name it, right? Your relative, your brother or sister, I suppose, your father, right? Or your mother, right? When the game ends, you totally understand what this living itself was worth it, actually, when you play games like Terranigma, because everything about this game is beautiful. That's why we play games, people, because the games like Terranigma is actually exist, and it's just and this creation have a very important spot in my personal top, of tops of all best RPGs in history, which is RPG Legends, right? So thank you guys for watching. As always, right? I'm not supposed to just talk about a lot of gameplay of this game, right? About the features, right? I just talk about my feelings, actually, right? What I feel throughout the games, actually, right? Sometimes I make examples of the gameplay, right? Or but it's basically we've been a series of a podcast, right? I'm just talk about games. It's not supposed to be some sort of retrospective or review, I suppose, right? It's just my transcendental feelings, I suppose, right? About games, actually, right? Or just chit-chat about games. You name it, right? Terranigma. RPG Legends. One of the best games in history. And this game especially is a high-rated RPG of mine. My personal top 3, both with Xenogears and Planescape Torment. If you ever ask yourself, or want to play some, extraordinary game was supposed to just turn your, believings toward to the just this belief what you actually, when you want to give a chance to gaming, right, or to games, or to RPGs, you can try Terranigma. Right? You can play on emulator in any resolution, on any PC possible, right? At the beginning, actually, right? You will be kinda annoyed, but if you give it a chance, right, and go through and continue to play, something in your brain will switch, and there is no turning back, actually, right? That's the difference between the people with good sense of taste and bad sense of taste. Because if you got this inner feeling what this game contains something big, or this book contains something big, right? You got this intuition, or instinct, I suppose, right? What something inside of it are supposed to just be like an egg, right? It's like, an object, right? We're supposed to be living being inside of it, right? And I don't know, just this game, you can make example like these games become somewhat like a sun, right? And the planets or people supposed to just, float around this sun, right? And just continue to just feel the warm. Feeling, right, of beginning of something new, right, for you as an adventure, again and again, right? It's like our world is colliding, right, every time, and it's like we just move on the spiral, right, and we just continue to experience something new, even if we already just know something, like you just already played dozens of games, right? But some certain game will give you a revelation, right? And it's not only about the games, it's about the books, about any human being creation as well, actually, right? Like movies, right? Or art, or any, any type. Like, manga, anime, you name it, right? It all depends on the talent of a person. And transcendental feeling, right? And Terranigma is a pure transcendence, right? This game have a quintet, put a huge amount of transcendental madness inside of it, right? And it's continue to just be a legend among legends, which is Terranigma.